Welcome to another Kaladesh Draft. I don't remember what it was for a second, which is weird. I was about to say Cube Draft because I've done so many. Anyway, welcome to another Kaladesh Draft here on channelfireball.com or twitch.tv/LSV, whatever it is you prefer. Let's see what we got. We've got a Skyship Stalker. This is a good card. It's a dragon, first of all. Dragons are good. 3/3 flying for 4 is great. You can pump its power. It's got fire breathing, gains first strike, gains haste. Great on 4 mana, great on 10 mana. Sounds like a good card. The next best card is probably Imperial Voyager. This card's also very good. 2/3 Flying Trample. I will not say the other word for that. Whenever it hits them, you get some energy. It's also Chandra's Pyro Helix, Propeller Pioneer, Kujar Seed Sculptor, and all that. But I will go ahead and take Skyship Stalker. Thornmallow, Leonard's Malasadas. Leonard's Bakery is the place to get Malasadas. It's not even close. What do we got next here? We have Snarethopter. Snarethopter is very good. 3/2 Flying Haste is a beater. It's also colorless, which is nice. Ballista Charger is not bad. But I don't like the Crew 3 vehicles all that much. Acrobatic Maneuver and Gearshift Ace are both fine. This cruise vehicle gives him first strike. This blinks a creature and you draw a card. Malfunction's okay. I like Prophetic Prism a lot. MB Keller, welcome to Divination. I'm probably going to take Snarethopter. First of all, it goes with my theme of 4 mana, 3 power flying creatures. Also, it's colorless. I don't have to commit to a second color. When you have a double red card, you don't really want to commit to a second color. And Snarethopter's probably just the best card in the pack, even aside from being colorless. Alright, what do we got now? Got a Pima Outrider is likely the best card. Pima Outrider is a basically 4 mana 4/4 trample with some upside because sometimes you can make a 1/1. There's Malfunction. Durable Handicraft is decent, but I think it's worse than Pima Outrider. I mean, I don't mind Live Fast. I don't see myself taking Bastion Mastodon here. So it's really Malfunction, Live Fast, or Pima Outrider. Guess I'll take Pima Outrider. Yeah, I mean, I could take Live Fast. That might be better. Just because I think Black Red's better than Red Green, but I think the green card is a lot better. I'm probably just going to take Brazen Scourge here. The best way to prepare a Scourge is to Braze it, I found. And I already have a great red card, so I want to cut off red. Also, it's just a good card. I think it's the best card in the pack. I mean, Aether Tradence is a fine card. Windrake's okay. Doomed Operative is not too bad. Alright, but I will take the Brazen Scourge. And then follow it up with probably a Built to Smash. I'm looking kind of beat down here. And Built to Smash is a nice one. There's also Engineered Might, doesn't really fit with what I have. There's Thriving Turtle, which isn't bad, especially since you can go to the air and then have a turtle back to block. Bum, bum, bum. Ooh, DW Poker, the Master Chef himself. I'm not sure if runner-up still. The most masterful chef I know. If he's giving Brazen Scourge a, you know, a thumbs up, then I guess it's probably delicious. There's also Salivating Gremlins, which might be the pick here. If I end up red-green, I'd much rather have Built to Smash, but I'm not greener by any stretch. If I end up, like, black-red or red-blue, Gremlins is probably better. I think I'm just going to take the Gremlins, actually. We'll see. I mean, there's also a red Puzzle Knot, I suppose. Yeah, Salivating Gremlins does curve nicely into Snarethopter. We'll say that. Now there's another Built to Smash, an Eager Construct, a lot of Wild Wanderers. Aviary Mechanic is a pretty good card. It's also Spontaneous Artist to go with the Haste theme. Haste, 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 haste. I don't think I want Eager Construct. What is up, Mulibok? I don't think I want Wild Wanderer, so I think it's going to be one of the red cards. I could see taking Aviary Mechanic here. I like it more than Impeccable Timing, but yeah, I'm not locked into green by any stretch. Maybe the Spontaneous Artist is just better, though. Yeah, I'll just take Spontaneous Artist. We need more 4 drops. We'll get another 4 drop. Might just take Windrake here. If I'm red-blue beatdown, especially since it makes Salivating Gremlins better, that could be interesting. It's also Live Fast, so it's one of these two cards, but I think Windrake goes with this plan better. I have not been impressed with Incendiary Sabotage so far. Maybe I'm wrong, though. Maybe the card is great. I'm just going to take the Windrake. Probably take Thriving Grubs now over Accomplished Automaton. I do like this card. Ambitious Etherborn is not too bad. But I think the Grubs is where I want to be. Kujar Seed Sculptor is a good card. I like it more than the Harrier, so I'll take the Seed Sculptor now. That is a late Seed Sculptor. I don't like Curio Vendor or Disappearing Axe, so late Seed Sculptor, late Live Fast, and a Malphite Squad. Interesting. And an Acherac Mover. These are all fine cards. I don't like Hijack very much. I'm going to take Live Fast over Malship Squad because I have so many 4-drops already. I guess there's Ornamental Courage. Maybe this is just the deck that wants Ornamental Courage, and I end up... Yeah, actually, but that's such a late... I'll just take Ornamental Courage. I don't know. So I'll take Terror of the Fairgrounds here over Prakata Club Security. Take Ruinous Gremlin. I think that's more of a sideboard card. Alright, well, that's a very good sign. Built to Smash that late is great. So, I am not considering myself anything but red here, and we'll see what I open. So, yeah, this is pretty good. What up, Decadang? Dang. Alright, I think we're in good shape here. The fact that we have 7 good red cards, including getting second to last pick Built to Smash, means that we have a... Red is open enough that we can just go in almost any direction, which means that if we open just a great white card or something, we can just take it. Like, well, like Skywither Shot, that card is almost assuredly the best card in this pack for us down there. I do like Inventor's Fair, but obviously I like Restoration Gearsmith, but Skywither Shot is just a great removal spell. It's enough better than Spontaneous Artist that I'll take it. I mean, there's 3 green cards here, but yeah, I think I'm supposed to take Skywiller Shot. Not that white is particularly open, but we don't have a reason to take like a Accomplished Automaton, and taking Dai Young is just taking a worse Skywiller Shot. So yeah, I'll just take that and see where we end up. Dun, dun, dun. And we'll see. Quicksmith Genius, yeah. Like my favorite picture of the set. Revoke Privileges, Sky Skiff, Experimental Aviator. I do like Aviator with the Brazen Scourge, the Salivating Gremlins. Another Sabotage. Might just take Quicksmith Genius. There's also Sky Skiff and Revoke. Yeah, see, this is one of those picks where I'm just right now in the format, because I don't know how good this card is. Feeling a little lost, yes. I guess I could take Revoke to go with my removal spells. Could take Aviator here. Boom, boom, boom. No, red is good. I'm still think this draft is going to end up going in a good place, but I just don't know what direction that is. Yeah, I guess I'll just take Revoke here. I don't know. Okay. Well, I think we're going to move into red-white. I think I might just take Visionary Augmenter. It's great with Gremlins. It's just a very good card. There's also Laugh New Hellion, but I only have the 1 energy card right now. Artist doesn't really count. And this card seems good ahead or behind, whereas the Hellion's very bad when you're behind. So I think I'm Visionary Augmenting. Try to wheel a Salivating Gremlins. There's a good chance I do that, I think, given how the first pack went. Jeez, Cultivator Blades, that card is very good. I'm going to take Weldfast Monitor, though. I think that at this point I should not be taking green cards. Though, yeah. Good stuff, Snow Schwartz. I'm just going to take Weldfast Monitor. I like the card. 3-2, Gids Menace, it's decent. And there's a Sea Sculptor. It's okay, I'll take a Sky Swirl Harrier. I think the Harrier is fine. Thing is, I didn't really see much green pack one. I mean, I saw a Pima Outrider and Kujar Seed Sculptor Wield, but other than that, I didn't see a whole lot of green pack one. Not that I saw a lot of white either, so I guess that's kind of a wash, but I think I'm supposed to stay in white here. I don't know. It is close. I'll take Spontaneous Artist. This card is fine. The thing is, the Cultivator, without... If you draw a combat trick with it, it's really good. If you don't, I guess it's still a 3-3 that if it attacks, you just win the game, but... I don't know. It's close. X-Tubo, welcome to the Divination. Bam. Join us. As I take millions of spontaneous artists here. Yeah, sure. Got a lot of 4-drops. That I do. I might take Inspired Charge here. I guess I could take Bastion Mastodon. It's kind of nice with all the spontaneous artists. And besides the one Visionary Augmenter, I'm not really going wide, so yeah, I'll take Mastodon here. Good stuff, Hiblayers. What time is it in Australia? It is 2 p.m.? Something like that? This pack was not as good as pack 1, but I think pack 3 is going to be good. We'll see. Am I going to Grand Prix Louisville in January? My guess is no. The Widigo just subscribed. Welcome, the Widigo. It's a decent card in Ice Age, not a great one. I'll take Spireside Infiltrator just because I need 3-drops over 4-drops. I guess I'll take the Incendiary Sabotage now. I didn't start that many artifacts. I'm just going to take Renegade Tactics, actually. This deck, I think Sabotage actually ended up being kind of bad. All right, another Built to Smash. Oh, Built to Smash also a reason to take something like Mastodon or Monitor. It does get a little better with artifact creatures. I don't like Torch Gauntlet, so I'm just going to not run it here. I'm probably not running Hijack, but it's nice to have the option too. I still only have 4 white cards. I guess 3 of them are pretty good. So, alright, let's open. I guess I open a good red card pack 3 here. MM Sword, yeah, Carnage Hollow Fries are close enough to Brito. They count. What do you got? Key to the City, Furious Reprisal. Nothing down there. Long Finned Sky Whale. Salivating Gremlins, which didn't wheel, by the way. Karthor and I am next week at the Pro Tour. Oh, kind of time to take the Key to the City here, because I haven't gotten a chance to try that out. DW Poker, welcome to Divination, Dave. Thanks for joining us. Get that Twitch Prime value. Glad to have you aboard. Hope to see you at this tournament sometime soon. I don't know if you're going to the Pro Tour. Are you going to the Pro Tour? I haven't heard anything about it, so I kind of assumed you weren't, but you never know. You're unpredictable. Yeah, Key's kind of interesting. I kind of like Salivating Gremlins too, but I think I'm gonna wait here. Jeez, PNLR. Dave subs and I get incredible luck. Shocker. Power familiar with the 4-month resub. Boom. You're thinking about getting a red eye to Atlanta? If you got the fever, you got the fever. Also, you're looking at me draft and you're like, wow, it would be really easy to beat people who draft like this. PNLR is just a bomb, so we'll take PNLR and we'll be very happy with her. I'm actually kind of feeling Sky Skiff here. I could take Eddie Trailhawk just because it's a... Actually, Eddie Trailhawk looks like it's a 2-drop, which, yeah, pings in for 1 or whatever, but 2-drop that can give all my, like, dorky 3-3s flying. Yeah, actually, that sounds kind of nice. Wheel and Little Built Smash. Yeah, who needs a Sky Skiff? I certainly don't. Oh, what are you doing to me, Cloud Blazer? You are very lucky. I will give you that. I'll probably take Thriving Ibex over Spireside Infiltrator. Maybe I'll just take another Bastion Mastodon, actually. Thriving Ibex is, I think... Oh, no, there's a Glintsleeve Artisan. Get the sleeve. Yeah, Glintsleeve Artisan. Easy pick here. Didn't even see that. There we go. I think we're drafting a very medium red-white deck, so I do like that. What could we play? play on the sideboard. I guess we could play Torch Column. Actually, Terror of the Fairgrounds, the 5-2, gets a lot better with Key to the City. Wow, this pack. There's Veteran Motorist, which I'm kind of leaning towards taking. I don't have any vehicles, but still, 2-mana, 3-1, Scry 2 is great. There's Welding Sparks, which is 3-mana, deal 3, sometimes 4. Propeller Pioneer and Reckless Fireweaver. Pioneer much also fragmentized. Probably just want to take the 2-drop here is my guess. Over Welding Sparks, because Key to the City, double built to smash, revoke shot. Yeah, I have some removal. All right, we'll take Veteran Motorist here. Vroom, vroom. Carry on my Wayward Giant. Yeah, sure. I'll take a Wayward Giant. And Servo Exhibition. You got Servoed? I only have the one Salivating Gremlin, so it's not like I really need to make artifacts here. Might just take another Eddie Trailhawk. That actually seems kind of great. I've got so many fours that I don't want Propeller Pioneer. Ooh, Aviary Mechanic with like PNLR, Glitzy Bartisan, Veteran Motorist. Yeah, that's going to be good. The Wonderful Platypus. Welcome to Divination. Alright, now I get to cut like Renegade Tactics. Probably one of my dorky fours, though. I probably don't need the third Spontaneous Artist. Ooh, I do like Wheeling Salivating Gremlins, though. Because I can also cut Spireside Infiltrator that way. Yeah, I don't like Eager Construct all that much. I mean, Gremlin's not insane here, but I think it's decent. I've got a couple artifacts. Red was open. Alright, I'll take a Quicksmith Genius, I guess. I could take another Wayward Giant here. Maybe I'm not even going to play Quicksmith Genius, so... Sure. Another built to smash. Probably don't need three of those. I'm probably not playing all the fives. I might just take out Sky Swirl Harry. The fact that I have two Eddie Trailhawks and two Spontaneous Artists makes me want Wayward Giant a lot more. Okay. Millions of Spontaneous Artists. And Hijacks. Alright. I haven't opened any masterpieces in any of these drafts. It's kind of nonsense, actually. Let's see. Do you want to cut anything? Or just play 16 lands? I guess... I have some flood protection here. Like, I have Key to the City. I have PNLR. Avery Mechanic is kind of good in the late game. We could play Mono Red here, but I don't think there's a reason to do that. I think our white cards are good. Near No Saws. Boom, welcome to the Divination. I could cut a Spontaneous Artist. I think I like all the spells, so I think I need to cut one of these. Maybe I just cut a Salivating Gremlins. But I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 artifacts in my deck. I could just cut an Eddie Trailhawk, actually. I think Mastodon's better because it triggers my two Gremlins, and it's better with Spontaneous Artist, and it's better with Eddie Trailhawk. 11-6, no, probably like 10-7. Yeah, and then 10-7 also lets me cut an Eddie Trailhawk, and that makes sense. So.